There are a lot of neat geologic features at Missouri's new Bryant Creek State Park. You can see evidence of past environments, detect signs of ancient life, learn to identify different rock types, and appreciate scenic outcrops. Here we'll focus on features that can be viewed along the park's trails, which we explored in a previous video. Whether you're planning a visit or just like neat rocks, follow along as we explore fun aspects of the area's geology here on Ozark Outsider. Most of the bedrock you'll see is sandstone, made up of layers of sand particles naturally cemented together. Pick up a rock and tilt it in the sun. If you see thousands of quartz grains sparkling back at you, like the piece on the right, it's sandstone. Remember, this is a state park, so look but don't keep. In most of the Ozarks, sandstone is a minor feature, so it's neat to have it here as the dominant rock type. Next, look for samples with a smooth, glass-like surface and curved fracture pattern, like the sample on the left. This is Chert, an incredibly common Ozark rock that you'll often find scattered across the surface, since it's very erosion-resistant. Chert often appears as chunky, angular fragments, but its surface tends to feel smoother than sandstone's rough and grainy texture. Finally, if you look carefully, you might find some small outcrops of dolomite in lower elevation areas. This won't be sparkly like sandstone, but rather drab. It's hard to spot along the trails, but if you descend down to Bryant Creek, you'll find it forming tall bluffs along the water. This is a very common bedrock type throughout the Ozarks, but at Bryant Creek it's overshadowed by the dramatic sandstone outcrops. Many layers of sandstone are particularly erosion resistant here, forming distinct bands of outcrops. Notice how these tend to persist at similar elevations, reflecting the original horizontal deposition of these sediments. In certain places, these resistant outcrops have been undercut by erosion, producing distinct ledges and overhanging shelters. This probably relates to differences in how well cemented different layers are. These often seem to occur along small streams, suggesting water plays a role in their formation, and attractive waterfalls can develop under the right conditions. Groundwater emerges from the bedrock in various places, creating seeps and springs that support distinct plant communities. For example, clusters of spicebush are often a sign of a nearby seep, and water-loving plants like liverwort thrive in wet places. The sandstones, part of what geologists call the Rubidoux Formation, contain quite a few clues to their original depositional environment, though some are more common than others. Ripple marks are exactly what they sound like, the preserved trace of flowing water rippling across loose sand. These are easiest to see on flat surfaces of sandstone slabs. Another sign of flowing water is crossbedding, a series of parallel beds set at an angle to the generally flat sandstone layers. These form as flowing water deposits sand grains on the downstream side of ripples, and are best seen on a vertical face of rock. Flowing water isn't the only environment preserved in these sandstones. Mud cracks preserve evidence of times when the water was temporarily absent, leaving the ancient surface to dry up and form networks of angular cracks. When new sediments were deposited over these cracks, some traces of these patterns were preserved. Like ripple marks, these are easiest to see on flat surfaces. Some especially fascinating features to look for are masses of ooids. These tiny mineral spheres form in warm, shallow water, such as this modern example from a beach in the Bahamas. Here's a nice comparison of intermixed opaque white ooids and clear quartz sand grains. You're especially likely to find ooids in pieces of chert. Ooid formation may relate to microbial activity, a nice lead-in to some other evidence of ancient life you can look for. There aren't a lot of fossils directly preserved in the rocks here, but here's one exception. Off-trail, lower in the geologic sequence, we found several clear examples of stromatolites. These are mounded structures formed as colonies of shallow marine organisms trapped sediment, accumulating thick, layered, domed structures. Stromatolites are among the earliest known forms of life on Earth, appearing over 3 billion years ago. That predates even Missouri's oldest rocks. Modern stromatolites are pretty rare, though they famously still occur along the coast of Western Australia. We only noticed one possible example on the trail itself, but you're welcome to keep a close eye out. Another way to recognize signs of ancient life is to look for trace fossils, which preserve evidence of biological activity rather than actual body parts. A common example occurs when marine organisms, burrowing through wet sediment, leave behind burrows whose traces are then preserved. These could be confused with mud cracks, and the preservation mechanism is similar, but burrows tend to be tubular and curvy, while mud cracks tend to be planar and polygonal. Collectively, all this evidence points to a shallow marine or coastal environment for this sandstone's formation during the early Ordovician period, around 480 million years ago. Although none of these features are unique to Bryant Creek State Park, together they represent a neat collection of geologic details that help us better envision the area's geologic history. If you're able to visit, take the time to look at the trailside rocks as you hike and see how many of these features you can recognize. And keep following this channel as we continue to explore and interpret the Ozark landscape.